Hi Pentax Tips, I'm going to show you the settings I plan to use for Milky Way photography with the K3 Mark III. The K3 Mark III doesn't come with an internal GPS unit, but I already have one of these external GPS units. The satellite symbol is in the middle here. It's grayed out when it's not in use, and it has one band or two bands underneath to indicate its signal strength. First thing I recommend doing is, while you're on the scene that you plan to do image acquisition, you go to the wrench number 4 and do a GPS settings general calibration. And that's where you rotate the camera around each of its axes. It erases data complete. I didn't even get the last one in. And when I'm ready to shoot, again, on the scene, the spot where I plan to shoot, go to the still images, number 4, Astrotracer, go down to precision calibration, and do an Astrotracer precision calibration right at the spot that you plan to do image acquisition. If you didn't get it the first time, you just keep rotating in it until it says data processing complete. And next thing I'll show is with your drive button, make sure you're using a remote or a timer, probably 12 second timers. Best get all the wobbles out before it does its image acquisition. Make sure that you're in bulb mode, and you can cycle between your two settings with the green button. Between bulb mode and Astrotracer, you can shoot up to 5 minute exposures, but I recommend starting off around 1 minute or 2 minutes and double checking your star trails to see if they're trailing. The ISO in this camera is phenomenal, and it will be really exciting to see just how far up we can shoot this at, but ISO can usually be around in that area. I have the 11 to 18 millimeter 2.8, so nice wide aperture. And yeah, I'll probably be on scene with my iPhone and use image sync to frame and focus, and I'll turn that off to make sure I'm not interfering with my GPS signal. And yeah, fire away, and I hope that helps showing the settings to get Astrotracer working on your K3 Mark III.